Our weed of the week is velvet leaf.
One of the reasons we talked about HPPDs and keeping them effective in our fields is because of velvet leaf. When the HPPDs first came out, it was a game changer. I remember talking to seed corn producers where they were detasseling and they're opening that canopy up mid-season, and they said the velvet leaf just comes back terrible as soon as they started using an HPPD product, at that time Callisto. They just wiped it out and they had season-long control. They were super happy with the kind of residual we got. So when it comes to corn and velvet leaf control, I like having an HPPD in the mix. Personally, I like to use it post-emerge. I like to use one of those HPPDs with a half pound of atrazine where you can post-emerge in corn. So pre-emerge, I won't use an HPPD. There's a lot of different choices. I'd probably run with Verdict.
Yeah, if it was me, I'd probably go Sure Starter Triple Flex, but the whole thing is, again, try to get two shots, get multiple effective modes of action on that weed. Now, it is just an annual weed. That's the good thing about velvet leaf, but it was one of the worst weeds that we've ever had, so it still could come back to that again if we have this resistance issue. That's why you got to use the multiple effective modes of action.
You know, you may be onto something there, Brian, with the Sure Start and Triple Flex and corn, because they've got Python in them. It's a highly effective chemistry on velvet leaf, and Python by itself can be used in soybeans. So I'd add Python to your soybean pre-program, and I'd come back post-emerge in conventional beans with Pursuit or Raptor. You could also spike in a little bit of Flexstar for some more kick.
Generally speaking, we don't have a major problem with velvet leaf in wheat, but if you're worried about it, I would start with Sharpen, and then I'd probably follow post-emerge with Husky.
That's all the time we have for this week's Weed, but Iron Talk is coming up next.